So we are demonstrating, like, a volunteering app using the M365 Agents Toolkit. And behind the scene, we are using Azure AI Search for grounding and as well as Microsoft Graph to interact with the SharePoint list. So the idea behind it, I've been quite lucky to work for organizations who give employees time, like, for volunteering activities. So here's some pictures that some volunteering I've done, from gardening up to running a workshop at a local school. A little bit about me. So I'm currently working at Alanoid, and I'm currently MVP in M365 Dev and M365 Copilot. And up to you, Lee.
Yep, so my name is Lee. I'm a developer for a company called Simity, based in the UK. You can sort of follow what I'm up to on the socials there, so Blue Sky, LinkedIn, and also a Microsoft MVP. So we'll go through the agenda of what we're going to go through here today. So we're going to kind of quickly discuss what the problem is and the solution we came up with for the hackathon. We'll go sort of very quickly over what the solution is. Reshmee will do a demo for us. And then we'll kind of recap with some challenges that we came across along the way, and areas that we could do to put some time into to make it even better. So the problem we're talking about, as Reshmee said at the top, we find that obviously a lot of organizations do offer volunteering time. So you can spend some of your working time helping local charities and initiatives to obviously give back to sort of the local community. But what we found is in some organizations, and kind of anecdotally, it's not always that well publicized. It's almost like it's hidden. And even if it is available, it's very hard to know what are you allowed to do, what are you not allowed to do, how much time are you allowed to spend, what charities are you allowed to spend some time with. And what we've tried to do is kind of consolidate that into an agent. So the idea is that if you want to volunteer, then you effectively go to the agent and kind of say, this is what I want to do, this is when I want to do it. It will effectively guide you across that process rather than kind of having to do it all manually, you know, sending emails backwards and forwards and reading a load of documentation. The idea is that it kind of makes it lowers the barrier to entry, so it's easier for people to kind of get out and get helping. So from a solution architecture point of view, there's not a massive amount of code. It's all declarative. So we've got a declarative agent. We are then using Azure AI Search to bring in a load of documentation for all the different charities and what initiatives they offer and what help they need. And we're kind of indexing that in AI Search. And then we're using then Microsoft Graph to put the sort of volunteering and user information into a list, so we're kind of keeping track of who's doing what and when. So as I touched on, we're using Azure AI Search to kind of sort of vectorize that data and kind of bring it into the agent. Potentially we could use other data sources. It is, you know, sort of slightly more complicated than just kind of putting it into files and putting it in SharePoint. Obviously there are other ways to do it as well. We found it worked quite well in this scenario where you've got a lot of disparate data sources that are all, you know, formatted slightly differently. It works quite well. Part of this is we are using, we're using declarative agent plugins. So Reshmee now will talk on sort of how we authenticate with those to get the data out.
So we have some prerequisite and we've kind of catered for authentication to both the MS Graph and the Azure AI Search. And the solution to authenticate with MS Graph, I've kind of discovered it from Frank Corner's blog post, which kind of describes all the steps, but concisely, first you have to create an Entra app ID, specify the permissions and generate a client secret. And then using the client ID and client secret, we register those in the Teams developer portal. And then once we registered those, we get a client registration ID. And then within the plugin, which I'm going to walk through the code, we kind of reference that registration ID. through the plugin. So this is self-authenticating with MS Graph, and the type is auth plugin vault, if it doesn't get changed again. And then the other one is the Azure AI Search. Again, we can easily interact by API calls using an API key. So using the similar concept, taking the endpoint for the Azure AI Search and the API key, we register it in the Teams developer portal, and then we reference the API key in the declarative agent plugin to be able to get the data. Now I'll do the demo. Fingers crossed it all works. So So here, it's just basically like how you access like a team app, so the volunteering app. I have some starter prompts already, which are defined within the solution. So when like as an end user, I just want like to know like any volunteering opportunities, which is my company is offering, so I can just look for those. And then what it's going to do in the background, it's going to do an API call to the Azure AI Search. And it's kind of prompting me like the information, metadata it's going to pass to that API call. So far, it's just like nothing. It's just like very basic. So just the version and where the account is. And then if it works, it kind of pull up all the volunteering opportunities which is currently being offered. It's still generating. The other one, I kind of had the developer debug mode turn on as well. Otherwise, you won't see like the agent debug info, which basically shows you all the metadata and all the actions which it's happening in the background. So in that particular scenario, we can have a look what it actually done in the background. So it kind of listed all the function it kind of iterated through, and if it's matched, it would say match, and then if it ran any particular function, it just show you that it's been that's the function what's been run, like the match and selected or both picked. And then, so that's under the actions, and then the executed actions, we have more details, what it actually done in the background. So we can expand it, and then we'll see that it actually did an API call to the Azure AI Search, and then it put all the response data, which is kind of displayed. And once, if I'm happy, if any of the volunteering activities sounds good to me, and I'll just say create a task for mentoring at a local college, for example, next Friday, because that's when I might be available. And then what it's doing in the background, again, in that here in the scenario, it will call the MS Graph, let's see, hopefully it all works, because I have like the authentication, it needs to know that it's me, so that's why it's just kind of prompt me like to logging to authenticate to the app, and then what it's going to do in the background is kind of generated sample data. I'll show you in the code what I've done so that it knows what data that it needs to pull, so that it kind of generate all the metadata here that's going to pass to the SharePoint or to the Microsoft Graph, which in turn pass it to the SharePoint API to create the SharePoint this item. And if I'm happy with it, I say next Friday. I think next Friday is the 5th of September, which is all right. And then if I'm happy with it, I can say confirm, or I can say to amend the data to be something else. So once, say it's created successfully, even like put the link where it kind of get created, again, it's just kind of tells me a few more things that I need to follow up if I need a reminder. And then if I go to the agent debug info, again, in that similar scenario, it kind of went through all the actions defined within the solution and tried to find the one which got run, and it kind of show you like which got run. So I got the get user information and create this item. So I'll show you where the volunteering item got created. It's a SharePoint list, and I'm using the default house tracker thing template, and that's got created here. And then the assigned to field is a people picker, and SharePoint, we need to pass what we call like the user ID from a user information list. So that's why I have like the additional action, which is to, I think it's this one, executive capabilities. Yeah, the get user information to find the user ID from that user information list before passing it to the create list item. So now if I walk through the solution, I'll just start. So similar way like Heidi showed like the agent, the SharePoint agent, like from a UI point of view, like this is like the M365 Agents Toolkit from Visual Studio. And by default, when you kind of create a new project, you'd have something called a declarative agent.json, which has like all the metadata for that particular agent, like the instruction, description, name. And then in here, I'm kind of have some conversation starters as well. And at the bottom, I have like actions, and the actions refers like to plugins, and I have two plugins, one which is the MS Craft plugin, and the other one is the Azure AI Search plugin. And if I look at the definition of the Azure AI Search plugin, that's where I'm kind of specifying like what this action actually mean. So within the Azure AI Search plugin, I got one particular action, which is search through the volunteering data from the Azure AI Search. And then from the MS Craft plugin, I have a few actions, functions to, okay, I didn't show like the get list items, but it's just like send an API call to get all the volunteering tasks assigned to me. And I have one which is a create the list item, and the get user information again pull the user information from the user information list, and to use it to find the ID and then create the list item within it. And these actions, they are linked like to API specification file. I just need to mention about the authentication, which I showed in this slide, referring to the registration ID in the Teams developer portal. And all of those are linked to API specification file, where I'm kind of defining how the API call is going to be executed, like specifying like the URL, which is the endpoint for Azure AI instance, and like all like the parameters it requires to retrieve the data, and as well as the request body that is going to return, so that the agent or the copilot is able like to return the data appropriately. And not least, the instruction is where I've kind of orchestrating all these different actions together. So I'm just showcase only one particular one, creating a new volunteering task. So in here, I'm kind of telling it like to first call like the user, get user information data to get the user ID, and then assign it to one particular parameter, like assigned to the lookup ID. That's what the API is waiting the data before it calls like the function create this item. And I got a few more instructions like how it needs to format the data, the payload for the API call. I think that's it from me. I'll pass on to Lee to finish off with the presentation.
Okay, thank you for that, Reshmee. So some of the issues we came across when building, one thing is it can get sort of when you've got no code in the middle and we're doing everything from a declarative agent, and obviously it's generative, it's keeping it on the right track can be a bit more of a challenge. We did find that kind of almost too much information is bad, and being too vague is also bad. So there's kind of a sweet spot there of kind of getting it to do what we want it to do, and kind of stick to that. We also had an issue when we were generating the plugins, the API schemas, that we were using Kyoto, but it for whatever reason, when we were generating them that way, the declarative agent was just only ever choosing one of the plugins, never choosing the other one. And in the end, we used GitHub Copilot to generate them instead. We just said, generate this API, and it did it, and it worked. So not sure what happened there, but that's just something we came across as we went through. And another issue is that to get the user ID to assign into the list, we have to get all the users to find us, then kind of get that ID and then pass it back to create the list, which is a bit inefficient, but ultimately that's kind of the only way we could get it to work how we wanted it to work. As far as future improvements go, things we did think about, which ultimately didn't implement them, full CRUD operation. So obviously we can create list items, we can read back, you know, show me where I'm currently volunteering. But it'd be nice to be able to change the date or say, actually, I can't volunteer for this anymore. Can you remove it? Just never got around to that. Like I say, another one, I think a big one is adding some Azure function code or some code somewhere in between the agent and the API, so we can kind of be a bit more deterministic and kind of control it a bit better. And then I think kind of the kind of other one that I think would be good would be using TypeSpec for the API contract. So as I said, we tried to use Kyoto, and then we also tried to obviously we've got Copilot to do them for us. We're a bit lazy, but it did work. But maybe next time we use TypeSpec. And I think that's everything, Reshmee.
Yeah, and this is a list of references which I saw David already kind of shared in the chat. Thank you very much for your time. And back to you, David, or Professor.